Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about how to use basic numbers in C++. By basic, I just mean numbers in our four basic math operators: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. I felt this video is necessary as there are two different types of numbers in C++, that is integers, or whole numbers, and numbers with decimals, which can be referred to as floats or double data types. The primary difference between a float and a double being that the double can score much more decimal places than a float. Just as a quick note, if you are going to be printing numbers straight, you do not need any quotation marks like we did for strings. So, as you can see here, if you do something simple like this inside our bitwise shift operator and run our program, we do not receive any error and get our expected value. Inside of the bitwise shift operator, you can also do any math that we want. So addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And these will all follow the orders of operations. So bed mass or ped mass, whether you call it brackets or parentheses. Let's first talk about storing these different types of numbers within variables in C++. This is an important distinction to be made, as if you're wanting to use a variable to say calculate something with a decimal place, but you only initialize the variable as an integer, then you're going to receive numbers that are different than you would likely expect. But why is this? Well, as you can see here, if we initialize a variable as an integer, and the number becomes something other than a whole number, C++ will round that number down to the lowest next whole number. So even if we create an integer of 1.999, well, when we run and build this program, we will receive 1 as an output. So how do we get our decimal places to stay? Well, that is what a float and double variable data types are for. A float can hold 7 places, whereas a double can hold 15 places. So, if we convert the previous variable to a float, we can now print 1.999 without any problems and truncation errors, which are errors due to rounding. Additionally, let's say that we have these two variables, one being an integer and one being a float. What do you think will happen when we implement these two variables together? Well, as you can see here, with all four of our basic math operators, we receive an answer that has a decimal in it and not an integer. However, what if we use two integer variables and try to get a number back that we know should be a decimal place or at least not a whole number? So let's create these two variables of 7 and 2. So when we run this program and build it, we're going to receive 3 back, which is obviously wrong. We can resolve this by setting one or both of our two variables to a float, like so. And as you can see, we are returned the proper number, which is 3.5. So, one may ask, if doubles are so much better at storing accuracy than integers and even floats, well, then why don't we always use doubles when storing our numbers? Well, like many other things in computer programming, there's going to be a trade-off between convenience and speed. By using more doubles, we are increasing the size of our program, which, over time, and using doubles exclusively, will make our program much slower, which isn't obviously ideal. Because of this, over time, learning C++, you'll find that certain numerical data types have their own roles to play. For example, let's say you are counting the iterations of some looping formula. Well, in this case, a float or a double would just be unnecessary, as we only need whole numbers, and therefore an integer works perfectly. All of these decisions are just something to keep in mind as you begin to make your own C++ codes. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped you learn some more about how to work with numbers in the C++ programming language. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.